Well, hello, beautiful people. Welcome back. I hope everyone is having an amazing day today. And in today's video, you guys, we are finally going to sit down and we are going to see what all the hype is here with the KVD Vegan Beauty Good Apple Foundation, because this foundation is trending all over the place. It's on TikTok, it's on Instagram. And I have had so many of you down in the comments wanting to know what I think. Have I tried it? Am I going to try it? And so that's exactly what we're going to do today. We're just going to apply it, look at the coverage, you know, the application, all the good things. And at this point, as of right now, when I'm filming this, I don't know how many like days I'm gonna wear it before I put this video up, because sometimes with my filming schedule stuff gets weird. But I figured no matter what, even if it's just one wear test, if it's multiple, we can still go through. Obviously I'm gonna zoom you in and give you all the information that I have. And at this point, there have been so many, you know, videos, reviews, TikToks, whatever's made on this, that I really don't think it's necessary to go through and like give you every single little, you know, minuscule detail, because a lot of people right now, they just want to know the bare bones. Okay, do I like it? What's the coverage like? Does it last? And that kind of stuff. So I figured while I'm going through doing the application, we can kind of glaze through, you know, the description. We can touch on those things, but there's really no need for like a whole introduction. So let's go ahead. Oh, actually, wait a second. Pause, okay? Pause real quick. Because if we're talking about introductions, I guess I should just say that I should introduce myself. Hello, if you're new here, my name is Paige. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to Seeking Alexandria. I do put up 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, right around 7:30-ish a.m. my time here in good old Northern Michigan. So we've got some bright early morning uploads. And then also, if you'd like to hang out with me behind the scenes, you want to get to know me, you want to, honestly, if you really want to get to know anything, go with me on my day-to-day life, have unboxings, you know, little car chats, answer this, whine about it segments. I kind of live over on Instagram. Like anything that's going on in my life, that's where I hang out, again, in the Insta stories. And then I also post, you know, in addition to that, every day kind of checking in, I'm also in the feed a bunch with you guys, posting anything, you know, plus size fashion, styling, OOTDs, makeup reviews, you know, new makeup that's released, we test that out. So really what I'm saying here is, if any of that sounds good, you like me, you like my personality, or if you just want to hang out with me more, I would really, really appreciate it if you take a second, go follow me there, because I am trying to hit 10,000 followers. That way I can get that blessed swipe up feature, you guys. When I tell you, okay, there is going to be a party when I hit that 10K. You don't even know the party that will ensue on my Instagram when I hit 10K. So please, if and you haven't done so, please go follow me on Instagram. Everything will be linked down below. And then also everything that I can link down below, like out of the video wise outfit, which this is actually from Abercrombie and I am obsessed. Like I cannot get enough of this shirt. So this will be linked. I'll make sure to link the necklace or at least one similar, whatever I can find. This one is from Melinda Maria. All of that to be said, I will link what I can. But this guy, whoo, bitch, it is hot. Okay, I should be clutching this. I didn't realize it'd be such a damn collector's item. Hey, you guys. So I took my glasses, pushed all the little curlies back, and I want to start off first by priming my skin. And for that, I'm going to use the One Size Secure the Blur Makeup Magnet Primer. Okay, so I'm just taking that and kind of pressing it through the T-zone, and then lightly taking the excess and kind of pressing it over the cheeks. All right, now getting into the foundation, I have the shade Light 015, which is definitely a little bit too deep for me. I went ahead and swatched it, but it's actually not that bad. I think if it wasn't like so yellowy undertoned, I think it would match a little bit better, but I'll just go ahead and correct that with concealer. I honestly don't think it's gonna be an issue. I've definitely worked with deeper ones, and you know, even as you blend it out, it does a pretty good job. Damn, that's got coverage. Y'all see that? I mean, I know that's like the thing, but I haven't actually looked at it yet. It like covered that blue vein on my hand surprisingly well. Okay. Now from here, I'm actually going to go in first with a sponge, because technically this is a skin perfecting foundation balm. So it does have like a very, you can kind of see it in the compact there. It has a very shiny, very emollient texture to it. And I really do feel like something with this texture will just apply better overall with like my texture, my redness, my hyperpigmentation. I think it'll apply better with a sponge. So I'm just gonna dip in here. This is just the Dose of Color sponge, and I am gonna start by working it over all my redness on this side first, just so we can get a feel. Oh bitch. Okay ma'am, I'm listening, I am hearing you, I respect your thoughts. Okay, I'm kind of shocked. Okay, I'm kind of there, I'm kind of living. Let's just get it going here. All right, so I have it on about half the face right now. You can see right through here. I just took that one dunk. I never went back in. And I tried to spread it out pretty evenly. And I will say, as far as the texture goes with this, I actually enjoy it quite a bit, because over my more textured areas, like my more porous in texture up here, I think that it's pressing in nicely, and a sponge is doing a good job at like really settling that in. Now, in preparation for this video, because obviously with foundation reviews, I try to consider sponge and brush options. But I'm pretty sure with this one, you're supposed to stick... Oh God, my cornea is...
The sun is a dangerous weapon.
Okay, so as I was saying, sorry, my eyes just instantly started watering. But I think that with this foundation, because of the texture, I'm pretty sure they advise that you stick with a sponge just so you can get that nice press. But I still wanted to, just because I'm me, I still wanted to at least try it with a brush and see how I like it. So I'm just dunking in here, grabbing a little bit, and I'm gonna do one of these. Wow, that actually... God, that, like, the, wow. Hyperpigmentation-wise, like, if you have redness beneath your skin, like, veins and that kind of redness, I could see this being your best friend, because that, like, it just disappears instantly. And you know what? I actually don't think that looks bad at all with a brush. It's really, really smooth. And it's really, really smooth. Did you hear that? Okay, so far for application, now I'm just kind of pressing it in all over. And I'm going to be honest, I would give this a clean bill for sponge or brush application because truthfully, it looks beautiful. Now, I will say the only thing too that's kind of a caveat is that with a brush, this could, because it has that balm texture to it, it could get a little bit heavy, like over raised patches right here or over more porous areas. So just be mindful of that. You know, you could have a sponge on standby. You could press over top of it if that's something you're worried about. All right. Hello, beautiful people. Nice and close. Let's go ahead and take a look at this foundation. I really want you to get a feel for the texture and actually get to see how it's setting on my skin. Because I actually think it looks pretty, pretty nice. I am someone that has a lot of like fine lines and wrinkles. And based on the texture of this, if you also have fine lines and wrinkles, I can see it starting to like settle into there. So you might have to, you know, work around that powder, whatnot. But as far as the overall like coverage, texture, application so far, everything is looking good. The Hulk is kind of one of my main things up here. My big old Hulk wrinkle, if you're new. This big old bitch right here, okay? A whole world could fall into that crevasse on my forehead. And She just kind of dominates the face. So we kind of just give her space. We set her with powder. We move her on her way. You can see, that being said, all of the, you know, settling into the Hulk, the little mini Hulkettes, and the areas around my mouth. But again, everything else looks pretty good. Even like over my texture, my nose, I think everything looks pretty decent. Okay, so hear me out. Okay, I just realized that I'm like in the danger zone every time I move my head because my face isn't set of getting foundation on this beautiful new crisp white collar. And I'm really not all about that life. So bear with me. I'll try to keep the crinkling to a minimum, but I really don't want to wreck my shirt. So just bear with me. I promise I'll remove them as soon as humanly possible. I honestly can't believe this. So I keep looking at myself like, Paige, what's it look like to be a booty guru in 2021? Right here, bitch. Hi, how's it going? All right. So I'm going to keep moving through the rest of the face. First up here, obviously we've got some concealer. This is the Wet n Wild Incognito Concealer in the shade Fair. And I'm going to be using this to just kind of shape out the face because obviously this foundation is a little bit, you know, not my shade. So I'm gonna go in, you know, kind of blend it out, make it work for me. All right, so while we're blending, buffing, and, you know, just doing what we do here, let's talk about the foundation because there were a couple of interesting specs that I found out, starting with, and I don't think I said this yet. No, I don't think I did. Starting off with the component itself, this is something that I thought was really cool because at first when I saw this, I will admit, okay, I opened up the box and I was like, what the hell is this packaging? Like, it looks so cheap. It looks so, like, it's plastic. And I'm just like, what is this? Okay, it's like $38 and I seriously feel like I bought drugstore. But I was actually really pleased to find out that with this, it wasn't just like intentionally cheap packaging. They actually designed it this way because the entire thing, like literally the entire component, because there's no screws, no mirror, it can be 100% recycled. Like, there's not even a little tin that the product sits in at all. So this 100%, when you're done with it, can be recycled. And I thought that was actually really, really thoughtful. But that being said, I will admit, like, I think the price point is a little bit high just because the packaging for me isn't the greatest. Like, I think, yes, you did make it with a good reason in mind. Like, you made it 100% recyclable, which is great. But also at the same time, like, you can't tell me this packaging is worth $38. You know what I mean? Like, that for me is kind of a conundrum. I think that the, if anything, them not having those other elements, the screws, the mirror, the metal tin, those should have brought the cost down a little bit. But that's just my opinion. You know, I'm a big, big packaging fiend, okay? So I'm over here judging everything, packaging included. But again, the concept is still great. So I'm not mad at it. Now from here, I'm gonna go ahead and set my under eyes and my T-zone with a little bit of the Pure Translucent powder that I've been testing out. I actually did a full video testing new Pure makeup. They came out with like a concealer and a little face palette situation. So I'll link that video up here if you wanna see it. All right, so now that we're here and it's time to set the entire face, let's go ahead and just do a light little touch test just because I need to see with this one, like how set down do I really need to go with it? Like, is it setting itself? Wow, that actually does dry down really nicely. honestly, I'm getting a fair amount of transfer, but at the same time, it does feel really nice and like lightly dried to the skin. Now, here's the thing with this foundation, something that I have picked up between like the Ulta, the Sephora sites, as well as all over the rest of the internet. I know with this foundation, a lot of people are saying that if you have oily skin, this will not work for you, which if you're new here and you don't know me, I have combo leaning oily skin. So this is gonna be an interesting test. But I have learned, like I said, people that lean in that direction, like in the oily side, they typically don't love it like through the T-zone because you do get pretty oily. So for me, what I'm thinking with this foundation, as far as like a first test goes, I'm actually gonna take it a little bit easy with the powders, because the one thing I don't want to do is make it look really thick and really heavy, because right now it's actually looking really nice. It's feeling very lightweight. Like I cannot feel this on my skin. And for the coverage that I have, I think that is stunning. So I'm gonna go in with a product that you can't buy right now, sorry. This is the Chantecaille, what is this? The Perfect Blur Finishing Powder. And I believe this hasn't been re-released. They like took it off the market, they're bringing it back or something like that. And this is a great, great powder. I love using this actually with my NARS, what is this? The Soft Matte Complete Foundation. This is my day-to-day foundation right now. But I reach for this powder because it does such a beautiful job lightly setting down on my skin and giving me the set that I need without being like super heavy. It doesn't really make me matte or anything like that. Like it just leaves me with a nice natural skin finish. And so when I'm dealing with products that are naturally more mattifying, like the Soft Matte from NARS or this one that I'm testing today, it does just kind of help keep everything together and it sets it. But at the same time, it makes it so I can still blend and move and go about my day on top of it. What would you do for a Klondike bar? Bitch, there's not much I wouldn't do for a Klondike bar. I'm just saying, standards be low in this bitch. All right, now at this point, normally I would run off of camera, do the rest of my face and come back. But as of late, you guys have been liking, you know, seeing all the rest of the steps kind of go through the face. So I'm gonna go in here. I'll just, you know, put a little excerpt of each one just so you guys can see what I'm using. And for bronzer, I'm going back in here with the Charlotte Tilbury. This is the bronzer in the shade medium, their airbrush bronzer. And as you can tell, she is well loved. So I'm gonna take just some of this. It's a really, really beautiful workable bronzer. Paige, do not give a review of every single product. People have already heard you talk about this 7,000 times. Okay, thank you, management. All right, so from here, I'm going in with blush. This is, of course, the Moon Prism Blush Palette, taking a mixture of Twilight, Stargaze, and Soleil, these three right here. And I'm just gonna mix those on to my cheek using a Refer number 5 brush, which, by the way, this is the week of Refer, okay? I'm gonna have the link down below for the concept store. If you have not yet picked up your brushes, oh my God, what are you waiting for? They have three different items slash bundles in there right now. They have the number 4, which is their face brush. It's like this one, but slanted. It's the actual blush brush that I can't find, but it's absolutely fantastic, really nice, very fluffy. And that is currently on sale for, I think it was $23. And then they also have in there two different eye brush sets, their Original Eye Trio, which I think is like $39, and their new quad they just came out with. It's a new 4-piece brush set, and that is on sale for $52. But I'll have that link down below. Again, everything's in the concept store, and I highly recommend, because truthfully, everyone should use Refer brushes. They're fucking amazing. And I'm telling you right now, look at this big papa, okay? Do you see this brush? This is the Refer 22. She's a big old beefy face brush. Like this, it is huge, and it is so luxurious. I think everyone needs this brush. And when this comes back into the concept store, you will hear me screaming it from the mountain out back, okay? I live in Northern Michigan, and you are gonna hear me to the tippity tips of Detroit, bitch, because this brush is so good, I will scream it. Bag alert, major bag alert. Right now, from here, I'm gonna take some of my Fenty loose powder here. This is in the shade, what shade is this? This butter? Yeah, butter. This is in the shade butter. Y'all know I love butter. And we are gonna take that and run it under the eyes, a little bit along the jawline, just to help sculpt everything out. I'm not gonna go in too sharp or anything, but I just want a little bit of cut here to help give me back some definition, if you will. And now from there, while that's sitting down, kind of doing its thing, brightening up the areas of my face, I'm gonna do my brows using this first here. This is the Huda Bomb Brows in the shade 5. Such a good brow pencil. And then just on top of that here, a little bit of the Benefit Gimme Brow in 3.5, just for a little fluff and definition. All right, now for eyes, I'm not doing anything crazy today because it's just a foundation review. So I'm just taking some of that bronzer and lightly fluffing it through the crease here. All right, so now we go ahead, we dust off that bake. Right now I'm gonna go ahead, spray my face down before highlight with a little bit of the IT Cosmetics Your Skin But Better Setting Spray. And then for highlight, I'm going in with my Dior palette here. I feel like I've been using this nonstop lately. And I'm just taking those top two shades and kind of buffing them into my cheek. Hey guys, so I didn't realize my camera had quit recording there for a hot second. So just for the last couple items, this is the Maybelline Lash Sensational Sky High Mascara. I also went in on the lips here with the Mented Lip Pencil in the shade Dope. And over top of that, a little bit of the Essence Juicy Balm Shiny Lip Gloss. But now you guys are all caught up, and obviously this is the full face, how everything turned out. And I'm gonna go ahead and throw up the up close, that way you all can see like the texture of the foundation and how it's looking. Because so far, I'm gonna be honest, okay? So far, I like it. I'm not in love with it. And I think this is one of those foundations, from what I'm seeing, that the overall look and wear is heavily dependent on if you use powders or not, which I mean, that kind of makes sense because they do technically say that it's geared toward like combo dry, dry, or more natural or neutral skin. But for me, a couple things that I'm noticing are like around the, you know, the bad redness on my face, the part where I first originally applied the foundation, right in that area, I actually noticed that I lost a little coverage after I applied my foundation. And I know that that's something that can happen with foundations like this. And it's just something that I've noticed. I don't know if it's, you know, maybe it's just a me thing. I'm not sure. But there are some foundations that when you, regardless of how good the coverage is, when you set them, no matter how much you set them or whatever you use, it just can change the coverage because it kind of affects that formula. Now, aside from that coverage though, the only other thing I'm noticing is my nose, which this is really, really common for me. And honestly, it's not that bad, but I notice a little bit of the settling into like my pores and my lines on the side here, which again, I'm not mad at because it is so, so common with me, with my skin type. It's just really difficult for things to like settle into all the big old beefy man pores I got on my face. But other than that, yeah, everything looks pretty good. Texture wise, it's fine, especially this cheek right here where I don't have a ton of texture and I really don't have much going on. It looks superb. With all that being said, I'm gonna go ahead, run off of camera. I'm gonna go do today, finish this up. I will obviously do a check-in. We'll talk about it and kind of see where things are going. And yeah, I'll see you guys here in a little bit.
Okay, beautiful people. So I'm back. I want to talk to you about this foundation and finalize my thoughts here because I just realized I had to tear down my entire room because I had to clean a bunch of stuff. And I would have to literally set everything up just to like film this last couple minutes. And I'm so sorry. I know this is definitely not what we had in mind, you know, when it comes to a foundation review, but I'm still going to give you all of my thoughts and opinions. I've been wear testing it now for, I want to say 4 days, 4 or 5 days. And I definitely have some thoughts. So the first thing I want to say is, as far as the original wear test, the one that you guys saw, I'm going to go ahead and throw up on the screen how that wore, because what I noticed with that foundation wear specifically, when I went in with like that lighter finishing powder, I noticed that my face never really wanted to like fully set down. Like it needed a little bit more press, a little bit more coverage, and definitely a little bit more mattification, which we knew was going to happen from the start. So then what I ended up doing was I went in for the last couple of days and I've been playing around with both more mattifying primers as well as more mattifying foundation powders, like to set everything. And so with that being said, I'd have to say like my definitive thoughts with this foundation are that, first of all, if you're someone like me that has to be, you know, more on the matte side through your T-zone, I don't know that you're going to love this foundation because truthfully, I feel like it has a really hard time sticking to my skin. Like, I mean, even on the areas, not even just on the T-zone, like over here, I noticed that it wanted to slough around and move quite a bit. Like just even when I was setting it, even throughout the day, like if I touched my face, there was always a fair amount of transfer. And I really struggle with that because I, you know, I could see it having, like I said, a little bit of issue through the T-zone because it is more like geared for the other side of the spectrum with like slightly more, you know, dry skin. But I really struggle when it's like over here because I don't have super like oily skin over here. And normally this is where foundations look the best on me, is like on the planes of my face. And I just thought that was a little bit weird. So that right there definitely threw me off, number one. And number two, my other issue with this is like my smile lines through here, the forehead, it wanted to settle in to every single little wrinkle, crack, and crevasse on this little 31-year-old face. And I just wasn't really a fan of that. Like, that's not really my journey. So while I will say that, you know, kind of to recap here, I will say this foundation has a lot of really beautiful aspects to it, right? Like, it has great, great coverage. The application is beautiful. And actually, you know what? On the side right here, I did like a little mini application just to, you know, record it on my phone just so I had it. And I did just a quick application with a brush, and it was so freaking beautiful, you guys. Like overall, the finish was nice. It literally went onto my skin that fast. Like, it takes no time at all to build this up, to make it work, and it's gorgeous. I will be completely honest, you guys, I am not done with this foundation yet. And because for me, I really struggle. Like, I don't love to give up on foundations. I really, and you know this if you've been here a while, I will do anything to make a foundation work, especially if I see potential. And with this one, and honestly, I'm grateful that I do, because like the NARS Soft Matte Radiant one, that's one of my all-time favorite foundations, and I only know that I love it because I didn't give up on it. Like, I revisited that thing so many times until finally one day I made it work, and now it's like my favorite go-to foundation. So with this one, because I do love, again, the application and the look of it on the skin, the coverage, and that freaking, like, the way that it feels like nothing. It's gorgeous. And so I want to kind of take those elements and maybe combine it with similar foundations, but that are more on the matte side, like my Catrice HD Full Coverage. You guys know I love that. I also love that NARS one, and, you know, just other foundations that I think might be good for kind of balancing out where this one doesn't work so well. Okay, sorry about that. Real quick, guys, I just looked in this viewfinder and I realized it's the end of the day and my lips were looking busty crusty. I added some more of my Fenty Cream Gloss. This is in Honey Waffles. I freaking love this so much. It looks gorgeous. And I just was like, you know what? Let's touch up, okay? Let's finish this video strong instead of having some busted ass fucking lip liner sitting there. But as I film it on my phone in my office, you guys, I am such a hot mess today. But again, all of this to be said, I just kind of wanted you guys to know where my head was at with this, kind of what I was trying next, because I really think it says a lot about a foundation and like the potential it has when somebody wants to keep working with it. Like, it has so many good things going for it. But anyways, you guys, I think that that's pretty much all of my thoughts. If there's anything else that I want to add, of course, I'll either put it in the description box or in a pinned comment. But at this point, I want to hear from you all. I want to know, you know, what do you think of this foundation? Have you tried it? Were you planning on it? Are you curious? Like, what are your overall thoughts and opinions? I really, really want to hear from you because this has been such a viral, like, polarizing foundation. And I want to hear your guys' thoughts. So drop them all down in the comments. Don't forget to, like I said at the start of the video, I will have everything linked down below, everything that I talked about, of course, in the description box. You can also subscribe, turn on your post notifications, and please go follow me on Instagram. You guys, I am putting up such good content over there, like content I am so damn proud of. So please make sure that you go follow me. I would really, really appreciate it. And I am trying to hit 10K, so you'd really be helping me out. For real, you guys, that's it for me. Thank you all again so, so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And I hope you all have an amazing, amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Bye from my office. Woo! Who do you think you are, Mr. Big Shot? You never gonna get my love. Oh, yeah. Ooh. Oh, my God. I have the heater on. Oh, my God. I'm like sitting here sweating. Oh, is there anything that says I'm a booty guru more than I'm sitting in an office with a dirty wall and a bunch of paper behind me? Like, hello. Yes, this is a 2021 guru right here, baby. Yes. Okay, you guys. So let's go. You know what, Paige? Why don't we finish? How about we finish the Fig Newton? There's an idea. Before we bust out the phone to finish our video and we choke, how about we just finish the Fig Newton? Crazy concept. Also, Fig Newtons, delicious. I've been talking about them on Instagram today. Because you know why? I think they're great. Only problem is I keep getting the crummy stuck in my gloss and then I keep eating my gloss. So really it's, you know, sick. I don't care. What was that? I don't care. I'm eating Fig Newtons. Bitch, they're so good. Oh my God. Fig Newtons. Fucking spice of life, my friend.